Hello, this is an example of an induction proof in graph theory. So here's the claim we want to show. If G is connected, right, G is only one component you can get from any vertex to any other by walking along edges, and G has at least two vertices, then there are two vertices, x1 and x2, in that graph, such that if we remove those vertices, right, if we look at the graph without x1, or the graph without x2, the remaining graph is still connected. So let's look first, before we try to prove this, at an example that might show us what this is telling us. So I'm going to choose a real simple example. Here's a path on four vertices. Let's think about what happens if we remove each vertex. Right, so let's start with this one on the end. If we remove it, then we're left with the other three vertices in one component. That's still connected. So now let's think about what happens if we remove the next one. Here, something a little different happens. We get this vertex on its own, and then we get these two, right? So this is not connected. And then the same thing would basically happen with these. This middle one acts like that other middle one, and this end one acts like this one. So the two vertices here that we're claiming we can remove and still leave us a connected graph would be this one and that one, the two end vertices. Right, and our claim is no matter what connected graph we have, we can always find two vertices like that. Okay, so here is how we prove it. Like I said, we're going to use induction. And in particular, we're going to use strong induction. When we get to the part where that matters, we'll talk about it a little more. So here's the proof. We'll prove this by induction on the number of vertices, and we'll give that number a name, n. Right, so our base case, n is going to be as small as possible. And how small is that? Well, our claim is true for graphs with at least two vertices. So our base case is n equals 2. Well, there's only one connected graph with two vertices. It looks like this. And indeed, here, if I remove either vertex, I still get a connected graph, right? So let's say this is x1 and this is x2. G minus x1 looks like just x2 on its own. G minus x2 looks like just x1 on its own, and those are both connected, right? So we've proven the claim in the base case. So now let's go to the inductive step. So here's where the fact that we're going to use strong induction comes in. We're not going to assume just that this claim is true for n equal to some k. We'll assume it's true for n less than or equal to some k. And then we want to prove it is true for the case where n is k plus 1. Okay, right, so we're not just assuming that claim holds for a graph that's one vertex smaller, we're claiming that it's true for any smaller graph that meets the conditions. So we have basically two cases here. Case one is the easy one. If we remove any vertex and and still get something connected. Right? Then there are definitely two vertices that we can remove to still have a connected graph. So we're done immediately. So case two is there's some vertex that we can remove that will disconnect the graph. We'll name that vertex V. Okay, so here's the picture. Here's V. And V has edges, right? If we've removed V, then there are these edges that are no longer in the graph that go off to all of V's neighbors, or V's former neighbors, I suppose. Right, and this could go on. V could have many neighbors, I'm only drawing three of them here. And those neighbors all live in components of the graph, right? These are all sort of connected pieces of the graph. There's not necessarily a component for each of V's neighbors, but that's sort of the upper bound on how many there are. Okay. So we have V, and we have all these disconnected components. So now what we're going to do is consider V, and we'll look at a couple of the components, right? There are at least two of them because removing V disconnected the graph. So for each of the components, we'll look at V, its edges to that component, and the component itself. So something like this. This is a new graph. We'll call it H, I. So I will go from 1 up to M, where M is our number of components. Remember, M is at least 2. That's important. So this graph, right, the number of vertices in HI is less than or equal to K. So the statement is true for HI. This means that HI has at least two vertices that if you remove them, HI is still connected, right? And in this picture, HI isn't talking to the rest of the graph, so G would still be connected if you removed those vertices, except if one of them is V. But that's okay. We don't need two of them. We'll only take one of them. So there's at least one vert that is not V. That we can remove without disconnecting the graph. So if we have one vertex that we can remove without disconnecting the graph from each component, and we have at least two components, then we have at least two vertices that we can remove without disconnecting the graph. So we are done. So what was the idea here, right? We inducted on the number of vertices. We checked our base case, that wasn't too hard. In the inductive step, we assumed that our desired claim was true for any smaller graph, so that when we removed a vertex that disconnected the graph, we could assume our claim was true for the components that we were left with. So this is an example of a strong induction proof on graphs.